Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, today we start the Advent season for the new liturgical year 2018, Cycle B. The message of the Word of God for the first Sunday of Advent can be summed up with verse 37 of chapter 13 from the reading of the Gospel according to Mark, which gives as follows: "What I say to you, I say to all, watch." There emerge some questions I would like to ask you. My first question is, what does the word watch mean to me, to you, who are listening to Jesus speaking to all of us, but now, but here, in this worshiping community? Let us trace the word back to the whole story of how an answer before traveling abroad ordered his servant to wait for his return. The big challenge for the servants was that they didn't know the time of the master's homecoming. This impressed them a strong feeling of suspense, a mixture of anxiety and excitement about what would happen at the master's return. However, they were sure that the master would finally come back because his was a word of honor. For this reason, all of them had to stay awake, faithful to do their assignment and ready for the master's return. This is the exact meaning of watching, not just watching someone or something, but getting on with alert and ready for a mission, for a full and active participation in a very important event that will surely take place sooner or later, though the day and the hour of which has not been revealed. The confidence that Jesus, our Lord and Savior, will come again for the second time in glory to put an end to all forms of evil and bring the final completion of the kingdom of God, we Christians all have, because we are sure that what He has promised, He will fulfill at the right time. This is also the reason for our celebration of the Advent season today. And for the second question, how could you and I stay awake, alert, ready for the second coming of Christ? We naturally prepare ourselves during this season of Advent for Christmas celebration on December 25. But also, and above all, we commit ourselves to keeping watch over the signs of the times going on in our lives every day in order to get ready for His second coming in glory. Sometimes we just keep complaining about practices and the fair treatment among our neighbors and even among our family members. Sometimes we even question God, where are you, God? If you are almighty, all-knowing, all-powerful, why this keeps happening to the innocent, bombing, terrorist attack, and even evil ambitions, corruption from the bottom class of society to those on top of power of countries and of the world? We need to come back to our good senses as preachers, as people of hope, as people of faith, and people of love. And we look at Jesus Christ, who after offering his own life on the cross to save all of us from the power of sin and death, went up to heaven, leaving us a very sure hope for his second coming glory, to put everything, to put everyone in good order as watcher by God the Father on the very beginning of creation. Remember, at the creation of Jesus Christ, of humanity and of everything that exists, God saw them good, in particular when looking on man created in his image. God even saw him very good. And we have to hope for the integral and the original image of God. In each one of us, when we look at Jesus Christ, the perfect image of God, who came down from heaven to reveal us who God the Father is, and also revealed to each one of us who we are really as to the God, as bearers of the beautiful, loving, caring image of God our Father. So again, sister brothers, we want you to put into the Word of God's message given to us on this first Sunday of Advent is clearly a reminder of our mission to stay alert, not to be tempted by the forces of evil, to be distracted from our Christian way of life, and finally becoming victims of the forces of evil, appearing in many and different forms, even in the most angels, according to St. Paul, and even under the cover of people of good will, serving God's glory, but finally they are demons to make us go straight from the very thought of truth and life, taught us by the very Son of God, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For this very important message of God's word, we pray the Holy Mass for blessing giving all his watchful alert and ready for second coming of our Lord in our life as both individuals and as communities. We put all our hope in the motherly hands of Blessed Mary, who together with us on this first Sunday of Advent, waiting in hope and faith and love, those also in silence with a very